out of the recession. But if you look at those who look at the economy from the grassroots perspective, it's important to understand that the federal government action couldn't have been successful if we didn't have appropriate grassroots response to federal government policy. Let me begin by stating that we have a federation where state governments cannot directly influence macroeconomic policy. There are national institutions that are responsible for managing the economy at the aggregate level. How successful they are depends in part on the response of the sub-national level to policies articulated in the center. So while on the one hand we recognize the natural turn of global economic activities, we also recognize the revival of the Nigerian economy. Where we come in is that the objective of the present administration in Kogi State that have decided to emphasize solid mineral, agriculture, transport and tourism fits into an optimum strategy in ensuring that the Nigerian economy comes out of the recession. And I think that is the essence of this not actually being a state summit, but a national summit. If you look at the downturn of the economy, and actually if you look at the basic macroeconomic policies in this country in the past, no, since independence, we have always recognized that there's a need to diversify the Nigerian economy. Even at the height of the oil boom, policies always recognized that we cannot continue to run the Nigerian economy based on oil. If you move backwards again a year, you discover that the crisis, the last crisis of the Nigerian economy, was as a result of the collapse of the oil market. This is not the first time we've witnessed that. We have a national economy that is held hostage by the behavior of the international oil market. That is beyond our control. I mean, most Nigerians who are complaining, why the downturn, why? No, look, if you understand the dynamics of the global economy, that was absolutely nothing. Oh, no, not absolutely nothing. There's something, that's why we're in this summit. It would have been difficult for government to reverse that trend without going back to the structure of the economy and trying to change the structure of the economy. If we do not change the structure of the Nigerian economy, we'll perpetually be subjected to these downturns that we have no control of. And how do we diversify the Nigerian economy? I think that is why we are here. And that is where the government, the Kogi State government, has taken a very bold step in trying to address a national issue, not just a state issue. If you look at the depression of the last year, and you look at the fluctuations of various sectors, we say that the economy went to technical depression. But if you actually look at the various sectors of the economy, not all the sectors of the economy went into recession. Not all the sectors. Some sectors actually, well, although they declined, they never went into negative growth. Agriculture for one. So what it means that the counter-cyclical economic policy you have to put in place, apart from the macroeconomic and monetary policy that government always emphasizes, is the structural transformation of the economy. And how do you restructure the Nigerian economy? The government itself has accepted that one of the ways of doing it is to make sure we promote the non-oil sector of the economy. It means that those states that are blessed with non-oil resources are in a position to drive the counter-cyclical policy that will ensure that Nigeria remains on a growth trajectory devoid of massive swings that originates from the oil sector. Kogi State, and I say very emphatically as an economist, is probably one of the states in this country that have the most natural resources that, if developed, will enable that counter-cyclical policy. It is not just for the state, but for the nation as a whole. It is in the interest of Nigeria to try to develop the natural resources of Kogi State to ensure that the economy itself can remain on an even development over a period of time to save the Nigerian economy from these continuous fluctuations that results from the vagaries of changes in the oil market. So here we are today, and I don't think it was a slip of tongue from the MC when he tried to hijack our governor and turn him into his own governor. It wasn't a slip of tongue. For all of us who are from Kogi State, we've listened to our governor and policymakers in this state talk. And one of the main objectives, even before this administration, I was involved in the last think tank experiment of this state. And since then, Kogi had made this pledge that before 2020, maximum 2025, Kogi State will be the number one economy in Nigeria. So Lagos State, here we come. So that was not a slip. That wasn't a slip. I think you are just looking forward. And in the next 2 days here, various presenters will try to show you why that is possible. Various presenters will try to explain to you why, whether we like it or not, Kogi State is going to be the fastest growing economy in Nigeria once we get our acts right. And in the presentations, they will tell you how mineral resources of the state can be developed. Let's just focus on the Ajaokuta complex. Let's just get that done. And let's see the sort of industries that we get. If you look at the history of industrialization, don't mind people telling you that steel is no longer important, that there are cheap steels all over the world, so why waste your time and invest? You can't develop a basic industrial superstructure without working hard on your steel infrastructure. So we are pleading to the vice president. I'm sure the governor will have done his own lobbying. Let's complete that project. And let's get the spin-off industries up and going. Let's work on agriculture. Let's feed the nation because we have the capacity of feeding the nation. Let's introduce or let's assist our local population. Let's go down to the grassroots. Let's mobilize them. Let's empower them. Let's give them a voice in the management of the economy. I'm looking at my watch too, because I can't, again, as I say, I have to be disciplined. I still have 3 minutes. So in the next 2 days, you are going to be honestly treated. And to our foreign partners, Kogi State is open for business. And I think that's one thing I expect will come out from this summit. It will be very clear to you, for those in the banking industry. If you look at the gaps, I'm sure in the presentation you see the gaps. Most of the banks come in here, collect our deposits, and we want to see them invest more in our state. I'm sure in this summit, the various bankable projects will be explained, and you begin to see that we have the manpower. We have the educational institutions. If we fine-tune them, we are going to be not able to have the human resources necessary to support a sustainable industrial development of the state, but we are going to create an economy, a modern economy, that can respond adequately to policies in the center. May God bless all of us as we go through these sessions, and I plead to those of you who can help the state to please do this. To do so. Thank you very much.